Good morning, students. You have to take out your geography book, class 7. We have started with the lesson number 3, weather and climate. The topics to be discussed in this lesson are number 1, its introduction, number 2, weather and climate, number 3, difference between weather and climate, number 4, elements of weather. In elements, we will discuss temperature, precipitation, humidity, atmospheric pressure, winds, clouds. Till now, we have done its introduction, weather and climate, difference between weather and climate, elements of weather. In elements, we have started with temperature. We have discussed one instrument of temperature, an instrument used to measure the temperature, that is 6 maximum and minimum thermometer. Today, we will discuss thermograph. Students, you have to take out page number 32. Thermograph. Thermograph is also used to measure the temperature of a place. It is a modern instrument of measuring temperature. Here we have a picture of thermograph in your book only, but I have one more picture to show you. Students, this is thermograph. It has a revolving cylinder and a pen. The pen records the temperature on the revolving cylinder. The pen is controlled by bimetallic strip. By bimetallic strip, I mean the strip made of two metals, aluminium and copper. The thermal expansion of the aluminium will be more than the thermal expansion of copper, so that the strip can bend easily with the change in temperature. Let's read from the book. It has a revolving cylinder and a pen. The pen records the temperature on a revolving cylinder. The pen is controlled by a bimetallic strip that bends as the temperature changes. Thermometer, thermograph, and 6 maximum and the minimum thermometer provides temperature related data of a place. These data are used by the meteorologist to calculate the mean daily, mean monthly, mean annual temperature and diurnal range of temperature. Mean daily, daily wise, mean monthly, month wise, mean annual, yearly temperature and diurnal range of temperature means full day including day and night. Students, this is thermograph where the readings of the temperature are noted down. On the map, the areas having the equal temperature are shown as isotherms. Isotherms are the lines on a map connecting the points having the same temperature at a given time. Do you know? Thermograph is an instrument that produces a trace or an image. Which image? Representing a record of varying temperature or infrared radiations over an area or during the period of time. So here is the definition of thermograph. Thermograph is an instrument that produces a trace or image representing a record of varying temperature. Students, you have to solve this, discuss the following. Next comes precipitation. Hail, sleet, snowfall and rainfall are the main forms of precipitation. Hail. Hail is ball of ice more than 5.5 mm in diameter, jise hum ole padna kehte hain. Sleet. Sleet is a mixture of rain and snow. Rainfall is the most common form of the precipitation. The form of the precipitation in which water droplets fall on the earth's surface is called rainfall. Now, which is an instrument used to measure the rainfall? Rainfall is measured by an instrument called rain gauge. Here in your book only there is a picture of rain gauge. I have one more picture to show you. This is rain gauge. It consists of cylinder with a fixed funnel at a top. This is a funnel at a top. The water is collected in this jar placed below the funnel. Amount of water collected in the jar is measured by using the graduated cylinder. Rainfall is measured in centimeters, millimeters or inches. Precautions are taken so that accuracy of the measurement is maintained. Most important care is taken to prevent the evaporation of the water from the jar. And also, when the water is very carefully transferred from the rain gauge to the measuring cylinder without any spilling. Let's read. Rain gauge has a metallic graduated cylinder with a broad base. Rain gauge is placed in an open and level area away from the buildings and trees. When it rains, the rainwater gets into the graduated jar and then it is measured. Rainfall is measured in millibars, centimeters and inches, etc. The distribution of the rainfall is shown by isohites on the map. Isohites are the lines on the map that join the points having the same amount of rainfall in a given period. Earlier we have done isotherms. Isotherms were the lines on a map joining the places having the same temperature. Now it's isohites, lines on the map joining the places having the same amount of rainfall at a given period, in a given period. Data collected from the rain gauge is used to calculate total daily rainfall, total monthly rainfall, total annual and the mean annual rainfall. The rain gauge should be set in an open ground approximately 30 cm above ground surface in such a way that the rain falls on it without any hindrance. It means without any stoppage. Students, you have to solve this, discuss the following. Next comes humidity. What is humidity? It is the moisture present in the air or in the atmosphere. What is moisture? Moisture is a water vapor in the air. How does water vapor comes in the air? Our earth, being a watery planet with the oceans, river, lakes and sea, the water vapor in the atmosphere is due to evaporation of the water from the water bodies. It is a continuous process. Evaporation and temperature are very close. As the temperature increases, the rate of evaporation also increases. In result, it increases the humidity in the atmosphere. The instrument we use to measure the humidity is wet and dry bulb thermometer, or we also say it hygrometer. This is a picture of hygrometer or the wet bulb thermometer and the dry bulb thermometer. We find air and moisture in the atmosphere. For measuring the moisture in the atmosphere, we need to compare the temperature readings on a wet bulb thermometer and a dry bulb thermometer. Students, I have one more picture to show you regarding of the hygrometer. This is hygrometer. There are two thermometers. One is dry bulb thermometer and other is wet bulb thermometer. The bulb of one thermometer is wrapped with the muslin, which is dipped in the container of water so that it can be kept moist. The temperature of the dry bulb is higher than the wet bulb. When the temperature is high and evaporation takes place, then the atmosphere of the wet thermometer drops. This is because some energy of the wet thermometer is used for the evaporation. If the difference between the reading of the both the thermometer is more, it means low humidity is there. But if the reading is same, it shows saturation. Atmosphere is saturated. Now come to reading. Psychrometer is a hygrometer consisting of wet bulb and a dry bulb thermometer. The dry bulb thermometer is similar to an ordinary thermometer. However, in the wet bulb thermometer, the bulb is kept moist with the distilled water on a muslin sack or a wick. It is kept with the muslin sack wrapped with. The difference in the two thermometers reading is used to determine atmospheric humidity. The relative humidity is the amount of water vapor present in the air, expressed as a percentage of the amount required for the saturation at the same temperature. In other words, relative humidity expresses the moisture in the atmosphere. It is measured in percentage. Relative humidity is measured in percentage. Relative humidity expresses the relationship between the actual amount of moisture present in the air and the total amount of the moisture the air can hold at a given temperature. This is the definition of relative humidity. It is the relationship between the actual amount of moisture present in the air and the total amount of moisture that the air can hold at a given temperature. Student, this was a concept of humidity. Tomorrow, we will discuss atmospheric